Today we are going to learn convolution in inverse Laplace transforms. Generally, convolution is useful for obtaining the inverse Laplace transform of product of two transforms and solving some ordinary differential equations. First, we see the definition of convolution. Let f of t and g of t be two functions defined for t greater than 0. Then we define f of t star g of t is equal to integral 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u du, provided that the integral exists. Here f of t star g of t is called the convolution product of f of t and g of t. Now we are going to discuss convolution theorem in inverse Laplace transform. Statement of convolution theorem is, if L inverse of f bar of s is equal to f of t and L inverse of g bar of s is equal to g of t, then L inverse of f bar of s into g bar of s is equal to f of t star g of t. This is the statement of convolution theorem. Now let us discuss some problems based on convolution theorem. The first example, using convolution theorem, find L inverse of 1 by s into s square plus 4. So the problem is, using convolution theorem, find L inverse of 1 by s into s square plus 4. Here the function is of the form f bar of s into g bar of s. So we can take f bar of s equal to 1 by s and g bar of s equal to 1 by s square plus 4, or otherwise we can take f bar of s equal to 1 by s square plus 4 and g bar of s equal to 1 by s. So the solution is, let f bar of s is equal to 1 by s square plus 4 and g bar of s is equal to 1 by s. Next we find the inverse Laplace transforms of f bar of s and g bar of s. Now L inverse of f bar of s is equal to L inverse of 1 by s square plus 4 is equal to L inverse of 1 by s square plus 4 is equal to 1 by 2 sin 2t, means f of t. Next, L inverse of g bar of s is equal to L inverse of 1 by s, L inverse of the inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s is equal to 1, which is nothing but g of t. Now, by applying convolution theorem, we have L inverse of 1 by s into s square plus 4 is equal to L inverse of f bar of s into g bar of s is equal to f of t star g of t. But the definition of convolution product is integral 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u du, which is equal to integral 0 to t. Since f of t equal to 1 by 2 into sin 2t, so f of u means 1 by 2. Here we are doing the integration with respect to u, so we can take 1 by 2 as constant, equal to with respect to E, with respect to U means 1 by 2 integral 0 to t sine 2u equal to 1 by 2 into the integration of sine 2u with respect to u is minus cos 2u by 2 within the limits 0 to t, which is equal to minus 1 by 4 into cos 2u within the limits 0 to t, which is equal to minus 1 by 4. Here the upper limit is t and the lower limit is 0. Cos 2t minus cos 0, which is equal to minus 1 by 4 into cos 2t minus 1, since the value of cos 0 is equal to 1. Now let us see another example based on convolution theorem. Using convolution theorem, find L inverse of S by S square plus A square whole square. See, the problem is find L inverse of S by S square plus A square whole square by using convolution theorem. Here the function is of the form f bar of s into g bar of s. So we can apply convolution theorem. So let us take let f bar of s is equal to 1 by s square plus a square and g bar of s is equal to s by s square plus a square. Next, we find the inverse Laplace transforms of f bar of s and g bar of s. Now, L inverse of f bar of s is equal to L inverse of 1 by s square plus a square. The inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s square plus a square is 1 by a sine a t, which is nothing but f of t. Next, L inverse of g bar of s, L inverse of g bar of s is equal to L inverse of s by s square plus a square. The inverse Laplace transform of s by s square plus a square is cos a t, which is nothing but g of t. Now, by applying convolution theorem, we have L inverse of S by S square plus A square whole square, which is equal to L inverse of F bar of S into G bar of S is equal to F of T star G of T, which is equal to the definition of convolution product is integral 0 to T f of u into g of t minus u du, which is equal to integral 0 to t. Here f of t is equal to 1 by a into sin a t. F of u means 1 by a sin a u into g of t minus u means cos a into t minus u du, since g of t equal to cos a t. Here we are doing the integration with respect to u. 1 by a is constant. 1 by a into integral 0 to t sin a u into cos
at minus au into du.
Means we multiply the integrand with 2 and divide by 2. 1 by 2a integral 0 to t 2 sin au into cos at minus au du, which is equal to 1 by 2a integral 0 to t. Here the integrand is of the form 2 sin a cos b. So we are using transformation 2 sin a cos b. 2 sin a cos b is equal to sin of a plus b plus sin of a minus b. So integral 0 to t, the integrand is of the form 2 sin a cos b, where capital A equal to AU and capital B equal to AT minus AU. Sin of A plus B AU plus AT minus AU plus sin of AU minus AT plus AU into DU, which is equal to 1 by 2a integral 0 to t sin at plus sin 2au minus at into du, which is equal to 1 by 2a into the integral of sin at with respect to u is u into sin at plus the integral of sin 2au minus at with respect to u is minus cos 2au minus at by 2a within the limits 0 to t equal to 1 by 2a. Here the upper limit is t and lower limit is 0. T sin at minus 1 by 2a cos 2at minus at cos at plus 1 by 2a cos 2a into 0 means cos 0 cos minus at, which is equal to 1 by 2a t sin at minus 1 by 2a cos at. Cos of minus at is equal to minus cos at by 2a. Since cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta, which is equal to 1 by 2a t sin at. So finally t by 2a sin at. So the inverse Laplace transform of s by s square plus a square whole square is equal to t by 2a into sin a.